Hello everyone, Xenosm here. Welcome back to... Sorry, that still makes me smile. Welcome back to Hyrule Warriors. Sorry, I'm just smiling, but... Last time we took on usurper Zant, and we also showed off... on her name. Sorry, I'm so jolly because we get train. Not for all the moves, sadly. Though I think we definitely should have train for all moves. But yeah, this is Toon Link of the Sand Rod. I really like what they did. Sorry. I just really like spirit tracks. Out of all the handheld Zeldas, it's probably my favorite. Oh, we didn't get a show off then. Oh well. I really like the train. Oh my god! He's... Okay, maybe not. Oh, they didn't use the train for the victory animation. Oh yes, it is! They didn't even bring the caboose. All aboard! Aww, I'm happy that the train is getting respect. Because the boat from Wind Waker got respect. Because he was sentient. Yes, I might be slightly sorry that people are like, well, the King of Red Lions is better. When really it's not. The Colon map doesn't really have any thing that I consider interesting. The next two maps, and I believe I also have to do this one to show off technically, but it's the same map as one of the others, so it's like, pardon me. But the Grand Travels map is going to be the one that's going to be the fun for me. So, let's head to Death Mountain.
Leading a small force of Hyrulean soldiers, Impa stepped into one of the newly opened portals. The kingdom spread out before her seemed like the Hyrule she knew, yet it was somehow very different. Before long, she realized that they had traveled back to the era of the mythical hero of time. Awed, Impa began her search for the Gate of Souls. She sensed an evil presence on Death Mountain and set out for the ominous peak. And with her came the mysterious Sheik.
Yep. And let's go. We've got a scene.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, listen! Hello, Navi. Bum. Sorry, I just can't help. Don't bother, we've got this. Like I said, don't bother. Nope. I got a weapon! I think that's maybe for Sheik then. Clearly, she told him how Saria song went. I believe if you're playing a Sheik, it's the opposite side that pops up. What do you mean you can't advance with the rocks? What rocks? No more, and now all our forces can rush in. Goron's special crop is not going to be useful here, nor will feeding him rocks. There we go. Me. He's a red beard. We're not losing this to a bunch of Gorons. Most likely, that is. Yes, I will. But before then, I'll quickly capture this keep. So, I'm gonna have a bit less of fighting force to deal with. Don't care. Oh, really? Well, the good news is we can quickly get back in there. Now we can go anywhere. Yeah, this episode's also probably not going to be that exciting, but hey. Cheek. They're not worth your effort. And that's why I'm trying to get you here. My plan begins now. Oh, I forgot to get that. Oh. Boom. Yeah, it's not much to say about this. It's just a fun map. One bomb choose down. Actually, wait, what am I doing? Take out the corner operator. This one. User Ninjutsu. Goodbye. This is the one time that someone appears practically in an ending scene. Like, physically. And with that, that will be the end of this episode. Next time, well, it's time to just jump in immediately with Twilight Field, with the one fight style I just don't like at all. But hey. See you guys then. Zimmer, signing out.